top high-dollar items already been claimed. So, let's go on to the next one, which would be May of 2013.
May of 2013, Marty's son Adam graduates high school in Brownsburg.
Who's got 1989? 1989, anybody? All right, we'll come back to that. May of 2015. Who has spring 2000?
Spring 2000, family trip to Disney World and other amusement parks in Fort Lauderdale with Marty's family from California.
Who has September of 2013? Symptoms of ovarian cancer and what to watch out for. The reason that one has a little bit of significance to it. Marty and I worked an event here in September 2013 with Alan and Meg, and that was the last event that Marty worked. She felt literally perfectly healthy. She had no problems at all. It was a week after that that she was doing her exercises and felt what she thought was a lump in her stomach. And she went into the doctor, and by the time they diagnosed this and removed it, she had an 8-inch diameter tumor in her lower abdomen, and she had no symptoms whatsoever. The only thing that you can really watch out for ovarian cancer as warning signs are if you have to increase your urinary frequency, or if you feel full a lot quicker after you eat, it can be a symptom. And the only way that they can be diagnosed is either through a MRI or some kind of imaging or what's called a CA125 test, which is a blood test. But they call the ovarian cancer the secret killer because females just don't have any symptoms prior to, and it's almost always they catch it last minute, and by then it's a great big tumor and more than likely has metastasized all over internally. Who has October 13th, 2016? Marty had just had at this point she had been in chemo and going through treatment for almost 36 months. She had had a lot of damage to her colon because of all the chemo and had to have pretty much her entire colon removed. She was left with a great big wound down her abdomen. She was wearing what's called a wound bag, and she has collects all of the seepage that comes out of the incision.
2013. She would like to, she's a rallying cry for the staff. They're all pushing as hard as they could to make sure that she got out of that damn hospital. So she made the wedding, but she was in a wheelchair, but she got out in time to make it. And after that, she was in hospice care at home after that for the next few months until she passed. We're going to do one more, mid-September of 2016. Anybody? Nick, you got it?
Marty Smith.